Welcome to Lawyer versus Lawyer Podcast. I'm Gary Berger, and this is a special edition. I've brought into the studio today my mom, Joan Berger. Hi, Mom.
Hi.
And we are also recording this by video to put out on the Berger Law website some episodes of this because of this great opportunity. Debbie is not available to be with us this week, but she'll be on the next podcast. So this is not a typical episode of Lawyer versus Lawyer. It's a special edition. So my mom, Joan Berger, is a, when were you licensed to the bar the first time, Mom?
May 1st, 1976.
1976. So that's like 5 years ago. And, right?
No, right.
42 years?
It'll be 43 this May.
So when I was 10 years old, you started practicing as a lawyer.
Correct.
Can you tell, and you worked as a prosecutor and in a private practice, and then you were a judge in the city of St. Louis, right?
Correct.
How long were you a judge?
13 years.
All right. And so should we spend the whole time talking about your CV, or should we get into some nuts and bolts of trial practice?
I think we should talk about trial practice to our lawyers out there.
What is, and from your perspective, and we've prepared some stuff. We have, you prepared 18 trial tips. I prepared 13. And so we'd like to talk about, this isn't basics. Some of it's basic, but some of it's advanced. Is that fair?
I think that's fair.
Big picture. When you're putting this together, what are you trying to do when you're trying to teach? Because you've also taught other lawyers for years and years. What are you trying to teach people?
Well, law school does not train you to be a trial lawyer, or even how to go to court and what to do in court. It was amazing. When I graduated from law school, most of us didn't even know where the courthouses were. I think some of that has improved, but I think lawyers, I always say it's like a medical residency. Your first 5 years out of law school, you have a lot to learn. And so I think these tips, some of them look basic, but they're very fundamental to being a successful lawyer.
And you've seen that. And, you know, and as we go on in life and learning, we're always learning in life, and you need to surrender to that. And then the other thing is you learn from when people do, you see great lawyers who do it right. You also see lawyers do it wrong, right? And so you can learn both ways. Fair?
That's correct.
So why don't we just go right to, so what I like to do, and I like it when you do it, is to do, just cut right to it, and let's start talking about some of your trial tips. You go ahead.
Okay.
What's your first one?
Well, think about walking into a courthouse. The first person you're going to see in a courtroom is the clerk. And it is imperative that you don't lord it over the clerk, because you're a lawyer with a few years' experience. You must be polite, because that clerk is the avenue to talk to the judge and to make your ability to try cases and get along and set motions more easily. That's the number one.
It's funny you said that. I tried a case in December, and the first thing I did was I wrote down, because I have so much going on in my head about trying, I wrote down the bailiff's name, the clerk's name, and the court reporter's name, so that I would remember, and I treated them as people, and they understood that I was there to treat them with respect. And so that's funny you said that.
Yeah, it's not false friendliness. It's genuine respect for their job and the role they play, and they will get that. They will get that.
And not everybody does that. People talk down to them.
Right. They do. It's amazing.
People will talk down. You know, I have an amazing staff. Rodney's one of them. Casey, all my people. And it'd be amazing. I'm like, you know, why do you think you can talk down to Rodney? Knows more about how to work these cases than I do. Why are you talking down to him? He's the one who's doing all the great rowing.
That's the other thing. It's not a trial practice, but your paralegals in your office. Your paralegals, this is new to me because I didn't have a paralegal. And I got on the bench in 1995, and we still had secretaries then, et cetera. Now we have paralegals who are doing a bulk of the work, and they deserve a lot of respect, too.